Daytona 500, Chase Elliott, Dale Earnhardt Jr. fastest in pole qualifying, and then it's the way they finish their duels. Duel one in the inside lane, duel two in the outside lane. Here's how they'll all line up for the Great American Race tomorrow on Fox. A bunch of Fords there right in a row. And see where some of those Toyotas will group up. Chevrolet is amongst them. You see Jimmy Johnson to the rear because of a backup car. Casey Kane going out now for another practice run. Will start 26th. Michael Waltrip in his final 500. Corey LaJoie in his first. 40 cars to roll off tomorrow in search of glory. Matt.
Mike starting outside row 10, David Reagan. He's a two-time restrictor plate winner in the NASCAR now Monster Energy Cup Series. And I don't want to put any extra pressure on you, but our producer, Barry Landis, I understand that he was a pretty good little short tracker up at Flemington, but he raced under an assumed name. He's picked you to score the first stage. So, that's a lot of pressure, but a lot of good points up for grabs.
Barry's a smart guy. I like what you're thinking, Barry.
You say that all the time, too.
That's right. Well, we came here to win the Daytona 500, but a stage win would be okay. It does add a little extra bonus points and a little incentive. I told my spotter, Rocky Ryan, I said, look, I don't want you to count down to the end of these stages. You know, we don't need to have something in our mind that we're racing for these stages. That's just going to happen if it happens. I think we've got to set ourselves up for that last fuel run, the last 60 miles, 70 miles of this race. So it would be fun to be up front. I think we've got a fast Camping World Ford. We were able to have some fun Thursday. Our Daytona 500 engine, everything's ready for Sunday. So it drives good. I'm happy with the speed and the handling. So we'll see, man. It's a long race and a lot can happen. But a good start to the race would be a nice stage win.
More so than I think any years in the past, the manufacturer groups sticking with their buddies.
Yeah, I think that we all have something common. You know, we're a brotherhood almost. We got to help one another, and the more we can help one another, it helps us all. So, obviously, the addition of Stuart Haas Racing and, RPM and having Roush Fenway and, some of the other Penske Fords that are really fast. We've got a good group of Fords. So, thanks to everybody, Ford Performance, and Mr. Edsel. I saw him out here watching Thursday night. I know they're proud of those blue ovals, and we want to get in victory lane. They've been able to win some Daytona 500s in the last 8 or 9 years. And I think this one sounds like another good chance.
You know, when you look at all the history that the Ford Motor Company and the founding family have, Mike, Edsel Ford told me the greatest motorsports moment for him, with all the great memories, was actually here when the Wood Brothers won. He was sitting on top of the pit box with his sons, and he said for a father to be experiencing that great moment with his sons, priceless.
Yep, great multi-generational sport. David Reagan, second-generation driver. I think I recall Barry Landis running some street stock races under the name Dan Druff. I'm not sure if that was Huntington or Wall Stadium. We'll have to.
Marty Kempner.
We'll ask the stat boys. They'll burn up a few megabytes on that one.
Marty's crew chief just did what he told him.
So watching the five car here, Casey Kane, make these single car runs, we heard a report about putting the race engine in, and so maybe not 100%. Happy with the performance of it, and so they've run three laps the last three times out, and I think they picked up a tiny bit on this run possibly. I don't know if that's a gust of wind or if they actually found a little something.
47.52 by himself, 45.83 in a draft, so that just shows how much wind, how the air affects these cars when they all get grouped up.
Want to see some horsepower?
Oh boy.
The U.S. Air Force Thunderbirds were warming up this morning.
Watch
for their flyover tomorrow.
Watch this thing. Come on, man. Stand on his tail. Come on.
up and away.
He's got a passenger riding along, which we had a couple drivers ride along with him over the years. I know Ryan Blaney took a ride with him last week. I don't know. Eric Jones
also.
As well.
Yeah.
I don't recommend any. Oh, there he is.
Wow. Look at that.
I've rode with the Blue Angels before. I don't recommend any drivers that are down in the garage area right now that are thinking about, hey, I want to go up, take a ride the day before the Daytona 500. Don't do that.
Don't.
Make sure you have a couple days to spare afterwards. It takes a lot out of your body.
Yeah, you can't even breathe. Wow. I've never done that, so how would I know that?
Want to go?
I know I can't breathe watching them.
Why don't you go up for a ride?
I can't breathe watching them.